despair. Snow falls over my dead. Blankets all over my dead.
The mess sergeant is prejudiced, and he picking on us.
But
that's the
you're
truth.
Not giving
that's
any specifics. Right you're what? Strictly saying this man is prejudiced.
That's right. He is. That's right. And he picking on us.
Let's have some specifics.
Well, I'll put the mess sergeant on.
Not like you seem to believe somebody's discriminating against you. Is there any?
As soon as the mess sergeant sees me, go pick up cigarette butts outside the mess hall. Clean out that trough underneath the coppers in the galley. Always some little piddling thing that don't amount to nothing. Just to keep me from seeing my platoon sergeant, where maybe I can get off to mess duty and get involved in the training.
How well do black and whites get along in this outfit?
Well, before I went to NCO school, I thought we were going to really have a problem. But since I went to staff NCO school, the problems seemed to decrease a lot because people got to understand each other better. And, I mean, this school we went to really showed us ourselves and other people at the same time. And I thought it was advanced to the society of all colors.
When I say that our overt manifestations of unrest have disappeared, I'm under no illusions that I have changed the basic attitudes of most Marines. I think we've made a start in this area. This is something that's going to take a long time.
Best thing I could, there's any of you that didn't know about it.
You can't say, I'm gonna tell us, is that side of town you can't go on.
Now, the recommendations, a black studies course conducted by Mrs. Wood of culture on rehabilitation. These are his feelings right now. It may possibly be changed.
Well, tell me if you would, General Ryan, how the program to dampen tensions here, racial tensions, got started.
It began almost 2 years ago under General Wheeler, the former division commander. He pointed out the racial tensions that existed in the division and instituted a program that was designed to explain black feelings to white Marines. And after the incident of a year and a half ago in July, we expanded the program, ensuring that Marines had the correct information on all incidents that occurred, that they were provided adequate security within the division area, and that we established a program whereby legitimate grievances could be taken care of, and where we ensured fair treatment and tried to convince the Marines that fair treatment existed throughout the division. The evidence of success that we have is that the assaults that used to occur in the division area have practically disappeared. The number of personnel on unauthorized absences have tended to decline. And the number of people complaining about discrimination in promotions, in disciplinary procedures, have been reduced to an all-time low. The number of Marines engaging in mixed athletics voluntarily have increased. So on the basis of that, that's where I base my analysis of the success of the program.
How did you approach the problem of getting this through to the rank and file Marine?
We established a series of leadership conferences. Every platoon leader had to gather his platoon together once a week to be sure that they understood the policies and procedures relating to promotions, liberty, discipline, other functioning of the Marine Corps, of this division. And we established a series of seminars for platoon leaders, staff NCOs, and sergeants that emphasized how to counsel, emphasized understanding attitudes, both their own and others. And we picked sergeants, staff NCOs, and lieutenants. We picked that level because they deal most directly with the individual Marine.
Do you think it's really possible to erase prejudices or biases from the minds of the men by education?
Well, I think it's a long-term thing. It's possible. It can't be done overnight. Any other similar unit that I know of, but I'm under no illusion that, in fact, we find in our, particularly in our sergeants class, very strong feelings of, I don't want to use the word prejudice, but strong feelings on the part of all races towards one towards the other. This is universal in every Marine or every sergeant, but a certain number of sergeants and a certain number, and I'm sure that as if I were to get down into the privates and PFCs, that those opinions would be even stronger, because I found the strongest feelings in the lower ranking and younger men.
I wonder why.
I think that these younger people are more aware of their position in the country and the position of their race and their group, more, let's say, than I was as an individual 30 years ago. So they come in with stronger feelings. And this surprised me, because I thought that the strongest feelings would be in the older people, but I find them more in the younger ones. And that goes for both officers and enlisted.
You've been in the Marine Corps how many years?
30.
30. The problem of race, getting along, is it a greater problem now than any time before?
Oh, yes. When I came back to a unit, the problem was more pronounced now than I have ever seen it. In other words, there were stronger feelings and people willing or ready to take action on these feelings, sometimes action being irrational, that didn't exist even 3 or 4 years ago.
Decide whether or not it is in fact true.
You know, some trash, you know. And there's other people there, he gonna pick on us. No, man, that ain't no good, you know.
Okay.
We got to the mess hall, we reported to the mess hall. 5 from the same platoon. Platoon sergeant come in the barracks one time, we playing all our soul music right there, and he says, it's almost 2200. He says, you're gonna have to stop that. But he didn't say it to nobody. Furthest away. And the next thing we know, the next day we are messing with each other.
Okay, if this is true.
That's one. He's gonna tell you.
Okay. I come in a platoon for about a week. Just come out of ITR. The platoon is getting ready to go afloat, possibly get in a war. And he puts me on mess duty. I swamp bars, clean trash cans before I come into service. Almost 20 years old. I'm just a few years younger than a mess sergeant.
Hey, can I go ahead and handle this?
All right, go ahead.
Yeah, man.
I'm the senior line corporal.
Every time I want to talk to my platoon sergeant about it.
I think it is. Do you think that it's important for a man to be over there and serve a job?
I think it's more important if they want me to take a job of work to fight a war in this country, that they should let me get prepared for it. If I have to work with people, I have to know them. I don't even know the people in my squad. Okay. I've never seen my squad leader since the first day I checked in.
Has it occurred to you that possibly you were put on mess duty to get it out of the way before you got worked into the company, so that after you were worked into the company, they wouldn't have to break you out after you had got worked in with the platoon, so that they wouldn't have to take you out then and put you on mess duty?
Okay, what about the other people? What about the other people that just came off mess duty?
Then why
we go right back on again?
Then why?
What about
then why has the mess sergeant for the last 28 days just been meddling with me?
Has he just been meddling with you, or has he been giving you something that
he's been meddling with the five of us?
Man, why you gotta talk to this dude, man? He ain't help us, man. He's wasting time.
He asks the same question just like at the time.
He wasting time, man. I ain't gotta talk to this dude, man.
Let me ask you a question then. In regard to the question you just asked me. Would you repeat the question?
So you talking to us just like you're talking to people back on the block.
To have it exactly right.
Man, he educated. You know, he ain't got time for us, man.
I seen your kind before.
Yeah.
Well.
I seen your kind before.
You don't?
No, I don't really trust you, but yet I have to a point. To a point only.
Lieutenant?
To the part that you're going to help us. That you're going to help us.
Is better for me to go on mess duty right out of ITR, doesn't it seem reasonable? But when I get out of ITR, this infantry trash is fresh in my mind. I don't know why I'm in the infantry anyway.
Okay. But here's the thing. If they put you on mess duty for the first 30 days, you're
then I forget what I learned in ITR. Are they going to start from the ground up again?
You won't forget.
Or do they want to carry over?
Be quiet for a little while and let these three men over here talk to me.
Yeah, he don't care either, yeah.
Go ahead, talk.
Man, these guys don't know, man, like we do. We've been in the company longer than they have, man.
You too.
They don't know. They don't know that they all around together.
And we're just trying to keep them together. Two sergeant comes in there and he says, I said, hey, sorry, I want to see you about that, you know, problem we talked about. You know what he says? Gotta see the mess sergeant. We're going to the club. Got a couple of hands waiting for us over there.
That's all they think about, man, you know.
That's all. And in the morning, he comes up to talk to you. Knock you out. I get stoned just smelling him. And you're gonna take his word against ours.
Man, he's like the rest of the beast, man. He don't care about us,
I'm
man.
I'm not gonna
you know?
Take anybody's word against anybody. I wanna hear the story from both sides.
Well, we told you, man. The man pressed you.
The only question I've got.
You lieutenant,
what is the story?
Right, we told you
now. Tell me how you got in the situation that you're presently in.
Okay. We put on mess duty.
We went, that's the start. We went on mess duty. We got to work in the spud locker. Then the chief messman took us out and put us behind the line serving chow. Then come morning inspection, check your nails to see if they're clean and everything, you know. And he says, well, I can't tell if your hands are clean. And he took us off from behind the line and put us back in the spud locker. Okay, mess sergeant in the spud locker. He says, I want that trash, no order now, no order. He says, I'd like that trash emptied sometime today. He says, okay. About that time, he keeps checking some bags and everything. All of a sudden, chief messman says, smoking break. So everybody, we go to mess hall, you know. He's sitting down in the corner, getting our smoking break, and next thing, right then and there. So he says, okay, we'll go empty it, but we're getting ready to get our hands inspected. We're gonna have to be clean. He says, I can't tell if your hands are clean or not. What do you say?
Yeah, man, yeah.
Huh? What do you say?
I'm gonna tell you.
That's what did it.
Yeah, we have
that's what did
hours,
it.
Man.
He
we
didn't say that
hours.
Part.
Ain't nobody
told
me
about
my rights or nothing, man. They put me in jail, you know.
I've been kicked around for 20 years.
Before you had to put up with you. You don't have to put up with that talk no more.
You don't take nothing from nobody, man.
Not no more, not like that.
Something I wanna know here is if he was wrong in the way he talked to you?
He was wrong. Right.
He was wrong.
And then make
you
a joke.
Boy, you understand?
Have you
do it?
Yes.
Or your hands are gonna show because you're black, and if you get them dirty, you can't tell they're clean or not? You gonna do that?
Yes.
Man, I don't want to talk to you no more, man.
I don't want to talk to you
no more, man. We don't talk about something mad to you. Man, we don't talk no more, man.
We don't talk no more, man.
Never been that mad.
Which they're not supposed
to. Pissed off.
When they do, you are supposed to carry out the order and then complain about it.
All the orders that were told me straight, I always carried out. When they come out with this, boy, oh yeah, hands ain't gonna be able to tell them they're
gonna be able to do it. Do it right now. A trash can has been sitting since breakfast, and it's gotta be done right now, this second.
And you tell me if somebody would
feel. I know how I would feel. I would do it.
Would you make them repeat the order differently?
That's your lieutenant.
I come into boot camp older than the rest of the troops in it. Next to the 17-year-old kids enlisted, I'm an old turd, or an old man to these people. Coming through boot camp, I'm set in my ways. I have my pattern. I've had the responsibility of taking care of myself since I left school. These kids are coming out of school and somebody has to control their lives. Why? Because I'm able to think for myself a little bit. Did I come out of boot camp with a 3-2-3-5 in my record book? Where this young man, he has no idea what life is about. And he can come out of boot camp with a 4-5-4-6 because he's a robot. He doesn't want to know the reason why. Maybe he wants to know.
Hey,
but he doesn't realize that he can ask it.
My stomach hurt, man. My stomach hurt. Hey,
man. What you can do?
I gotta go, man. Let's go, man. We don't talk to this dude, man.
You all right?
Oh, man. Let's go.
We don't want to talk no more. Man, my man's sick. We don't
want
to talk.
You can leave. Anyone who wants to stay or talk can stay and talk.
No, man. Let's
you want to talk to him?
Let's go.
You want to talk to him?
Maybe it'll do some good to talk to him.
Hey, man. I gotta go, man. Let's go.
You gotta go, man.
Oh, man, go.
We all go, man. We all going, man. Let's go.
Coming together. We
no,
all
man.
Going. I've been talking for 3 years, and I haven't got anything.
Let's go, man.
I'm going.
We don't want to talk. Sir.
Come on, man. Let's go, man.
Here wants
come
to
on.
Talk.
Let's go. Let's go, man. Come on.
You want to stay?
You want to stay here with him?
I want to stay.
Okay.
He's out the set, man. He's out.
All right. Go ahead.
The lieutenant heard.
Like I said before, it's not necessarily, because in my own platoon, if you had come in and I already had a trained unit and I was preparing to go on a cruise, I would have put you on mess duty myself for the simple reason that you weren't snapped in with the rest of the platoon yet. And I wouldn't be losing a man that did know what was going on. And later, after we get on the cruise, on cruises you have a lot of time for training in this, that, and the other.
You don't think the platoon sergeant or the squad leader should give some sort of explanation about this? Because I see four black Marines on mess duty and I go on right with them.
Now, I would say...
What does this lead me to believe?
I would say that it could have been explained. But, if you didn't ask for an explanation, you probably wouldn't have got it.
The only thing I asked, why am I going on mess duty? They says, I said so. Go.
All right.
I tried to get out of the mess hall and talk to the platoon sergeant.